Hello, my name is Rohan Kokula and welcome to my YouTube channel. I'll be demonstrating Data Science Folio, which I created using Reactjs and integrated Google Analytics with it. So this video would be of two parts, understanding the structure of Reactjs, how it works, and also the folder structure, the meaning of each folder and each file. And second part would be on how to install and customize it and make it your own portfolio by doing very minimal changes in very less time. So let's start understanding the structure. So when you clone my repository, you'll find public folder in which there's index.html. So this is the single page application. So that's why there's only one HTML file in the entire repository. So later the components and containers are managed by React.js, which I'll get through. So there's a SRC folder in which there are assets, components, containers, pages, etc. And most important thing to note here is portfolio.js file, which includes the entire data which is displayed on my website, on my portfolio. So each and every text is coming from portfolio.js. So if you manipulate this file, the entire text would change. The alignment, you could change it through CSS, but the data is changed by portfolio.js. Theme by default, now it includes just a black theme. I have not made much modifications yet. And finally, there's package.json file, which includes all the dependencies, the libraries based on React, based on Node. For example, there's a typewriting effect on my home screen, which is because of typewriter effect npm package, which is included in package.json. So now let's understand how assets, components, containers, pages, and portfolio.js is interconnected with each other. So suppose you are on your browser window and you have successfully installed the package.json using npm I or npm install, and now you have started your server, your node server, using npm start. So by default the server is started as started at 3000, which is default port number for React.js, and when you slash home, that indicates that home is one of the pages. So right now we are on home page, so home is highlighted. And there's also another page called slash education, which is a React route, and similar for slash project slash contact. So this is the header in which there's also a fancy logo, and everything is wrapped up in a container. So now this orange line is the container in which logo is an asset, and home, education, projects, and contact, all these are nav links, the nav container. So you can have container inside a container and you can have components inside a container. So suppose you have h1 tag, you have h2 tag, and you have a paragraph tag. So the data inside it is being fetched from portfolio.js. So inside portfolio.js, we have different dictionaries with their keys, which are later imported through each of the components and containers and pages, so that the data flow is very seamless. So these three are the tags. So suppose you have icons, you have nav links, and those are wrapped inside a container. So you can reuse this container in multiple places, in your education, in your projects, in your contacts. So now this entire components are wrapped up in a container known as greetings. So now you have left side of your greeting and you have right side of your greeting. So in your right side, you have asset, which comes from assets folder, which may be any GIF or emoji or any format of image. So now this right side of the greeting is also wrapped up in a container known as greeting write. So this is how each and every component is a child of its container, and you can reuse the containers in various places without actually writing the code or repeating the code again and again. And also the magic of React.js is you don't have to reload entire page to switch from one page to another, just like if you want to go to education page. So when you click on education nav link, the entire page is not reloaded at all. Only the components in those places gets reloaded. So now let's see how to install and customize this portfolio. You need to clone my repository. You need to change the directory to datasciencefolio. Once you are in this directory, you need to npm install. But make sure that you have installed Node.js on your system and also npm. So once you do npm install, node underscore modules folder is created in this directory where all the libraries and packages such as Bootstrap, React Reveal, etc. are extracted, and the components can use those libraries from node modules. So once all the node modules and packages are installed in your directory, you need to npm start to start the node server. So node server is by default activated at 3000 port number, which is a default number for React.js. So here's my GitHub repository. You can find it from the description. So let's start with cloning. So it downloads all the files into my local system. So here's the folders. Now we are into data science folio. So let's install the package.json using npm I. So once your packages get installed, you need to just start the development server. It might take some time. So in the meanwhile, you could just go through the folders and see what does it mean, the components, the badges. Oh, it got started. So by default, it gives localhost 3000. Yeah, it took much longer. This is our home page. So if you want to change any values over here, let's say my name. So you need to go to portfolio.js, navigate to home page. Here's the sub means subtitle. So let's change to John Doe. Save it, and it is automatically compiled. So when you go again, John Doe is reflected here. Similarly, if you want to change the title, save it. Auto refresh. So I've used SVGs over here. You could also use the animated SVGs, animated JSON files, which is over here from lottiefiles.com. I'll be adding link to the description on how to add these animated JSON files to our website. So suppose if you want to change data science analysis, so you need to go to skills, skills dictionary, and here's the word. And AI, refresh it, and now it got reflected. Yeah, so similarly, if you want to change any particular icons or delete some icon, let's say I want to delete the Figma, so I need to find it. So here's the so I've deleted it successfully, and similarly for education experience and education, suppose you want to add another education, that is your SSE. So let me just so this is the resume, right, which is the right side of the layout. So I've divided it likewise. So suppose I need to add my third level of education. So just copy it. Refresh it, and now secondary school certificate, it got reflected. So whatever you add in the add or delete, it will be reflected directly over the website. If you want to add achievement, ranks, freelance work, or any of your experience. And similarly for certification and badges, you need to go down, and here's the certification dictionary. You need to add logo path. Obviously it's in assets certificate, so these are the certificates. You need to just give the respective path, and that's it. You can explore more if you want via pages, like go to home component, and see greetings. So here's how it works. So .. portfolio, which means I am importing greeting. So let's say, so this is the greeting dictionary I'll be importing from portfolio. So in order to use that particular set of values, I need to import it, and this is my variable now. And if I use greeting dot sub, then it would return John Doe, just like here. Yeah, so same for you can see edux, go to education component. I have imported competitive sites, basic qualification, you could just change it. Refresh. So now it shows experience and education. So it's 100% customizable. You just need to get little basics on JavaScript. You need to know about props if you want to change it completely. Props and use state use effect functions, etc. So suppose you want to set up your Google Analytics. So you need to just go to app.js and paste your tracking ID over here. I'll be adding a link to the description on how to get a tracking ID from Google Analytics. So once you get the universal tracking ID, you need to just paste it over here and rest is done. You could track your users, mobile devices, etc. from that Google Analytics app or a website. Thanks for watching. If you have any queries, you could just ping me up on LinkedIn or mail. Everything is in description. Thank you.